Hello and welcome to my review of the OTT box, otherwise known as the TX2. Most commonly known as the TX2, I don't know why it says OTT TV box, I have no idea what it even stands for. But it is a TX2, there are a couple of versions of it going around, otherwise, or it's one version, but has a firmware update. I don't know. This thing's been out for a while, and I've had this thing for a while, though I haven't got around to making a video of it until about now. I've been using it. It's very good. So I figured I'd have enough information to actually give to you, which is awesome. That's what makes a review good, right? Right? Awesome. So this has a quad-core CPU. It's an RK3229, and it can go up to 1.5 GHz or 2 GHz. I don't know. I don't know, really. I checked the specs of it, and it's different everywhere. It's not fair. It has a GPU, is a Mali 400MP, you know, the basic one that's in every single mobile device ever, especially the cheap budget ones. It's got 1 GB of RAM, which is, you know, very limited now, and it's got 8 GB of storage, of course, and most of it's taken up by the actual operating system, so you don't actually have much space on it either. Why to get this? Well, apparently it's got KODI on it. Probably not a big deal now, but back then, yeah, it was a pretty big deal. So I've never actually used it until now, so that's an interesting one. So let's have a look and see what we actually get into the box. We get the TX2 actual model, which is really, really nice. If you have a look, it's very skinny. Very, very skinny. It's very, very nice. And it's got quite a lot of ports on it. It's got a SD card slot right there. Micro SD, obviously. Two USB 2 ports. I do not believe they're USB 3. It's got a full HDMI port, DC input port, which is nice, and a Ethernet input, which is nice, and it also has SPDIF, which is nice. Unfortunately, I never use that because, you know, I'm a simpleton, I can't help it. But yes, it's very nice that it actually offers the use of Ethernet, which is very, very nice, and full HDMI, none of this micro HDMI or mini HDMI, no, just full HDMI that everyone has, which is very nice. And apparently this can support up to 4K, although I'm very skeptical of that. I don't know, I don't have a 4K TV on hand. I can't bother setting up downstairs. So, yes, what else do we get in the box? Well, user manual, which is always nice. Android TV box, very generic. Lovely finger hole. And we also got a remote with this thing, although I didn't use this too much. Don't know why. It turns my TV off. Yeah, I can't remember which button it was, but yeah, I stopped using this because the TV I was using it on, it turns the TV off. Which is handy, I suppose, but also a pain in the backside. Also, we have the DC plug. I suppose you'll get your regional equivalent if you're in Europe or America or whatever. I honestly couldn't tell you otherwise. This is the only way it'll run, by the way. You can't run it via USB cable. So if you don't get the plug with it that you need, I don't know what else to suggest. So yeah, let's get on into the nitty-gritty of the TX2. Let's do it. Alright guys, so here we are in the TX2. Now, I figured I'd show you a couple of the functionalities of the box. Now, this is a basic Android operating system at its heart. You can use mouse and keyboard with it, controllers with it, you know, you can even use a plug-in, a PS3 controller if you really wanted to. However, I'd suggest holding off on that simply because it's not the most powerful thing in the universe. Now, I've had this thing for months, maybe even over a year. I've had this for a very, very long time, and I've only just got around to actually making a video on this damn thing. I'm using a 32 GB SD card for the majority of the storage needs for this device. I install all the apps onto the device and then have everything else external. So, I've only installed a few apps onto this thing, because you don't really need much. This is more or less a media box, but I want to show you the things you can do on it, as well as it being a media box. So you've got the good old media, you can't go wrong. It comes with KODI 16.1. I believe there is a 17.1 out now, or maybe even more. I don't know. I'm completely clueless when it comes to KODI. I'm very, very noobish at it. I've only ever had experience with this. A KODI 16.1 works perfectly fine. You can add as many different channels as you want. I'm not going to make this episode completely about KODI. I just want to show you how cool it is if you haven't heard of it. So you can play your own files. It's basically a media player, and it plays all these very nicely. You can play your pictures if you really want to look at them. I don't care for it. The majority you're going to be using with this is the video add-ons. You can watch your own video files, which is really nice. Same goes for your music. You can play your own music, which I've got a little bit on here now, which I don't see the point in playing, because it plays music. It's basic. You know, you don't... You, You know, well, what's the audio quality like? Well, it comes through HDMI. What do you expect? But it can go through SPDIF. I wish I could test that out for you, but I can't. So yeah, there's a whole bunch of video add-ons, which is really, really nice. I've installed quite a few, as you can see, and just given them all a big playthrough. And I mostly watch anime on this, I will be honest. A little bit of movies here and there. The girlfriend watches a few movies on here, like Deadpool and that, which is really cool. Think of this as a really nasty pirate box, because that is essentially what it is. But it's got KODI on it, and it's what it shows. You can easily just go onto some like anime app and look at whatever anime you fancy watching, or maybe whatever the hell you want to watch, really. I mostly use anime RAM. Simply because it has all of Dragon Ball on it. It's got Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Dragon Ball GT, the movies, the new ones. They've got, I'm not so sure about Super. I haven't watched Super on this. I just downloaded that and watched it on a computer. But yeah, it's got Dragon Ball Z Kai on it as well. And the new, it's not new anymore, but the continued Boo arc, which is nice, on there as well. So I won't show that for you simply because of content ID claims and all that good stuff. Alrighty, as you can see, Dragon Ball Z is working. I won't show much more now. But yeah, this thing has KODI and it runs very well. You can upgrade this to 17, but you have to upgrade the operating system, hence why there is a firmware update around for Android 5.1, so you can at least upgrade it to 17.1, but it's not a big deal. I don't see the point in it personally. So let's leave KODI. KODI works perfectly fine. I'd show you it working, but content ID claims. It works perfectly fine. Alrighty, so next up on the list is Beam, because Beam is a beautiful website. Now, you can complain about it because it's owned by Microsoft, but you cannot fault its platform. The platform is absolutely phenomenal, and the app runs as expected. It's a great streaming app. You can interact with streamers via the chat, the interaction board, as well as watching the stream all at the same time. It's really, really good. We'll just click on a completely random stream right now. Let's see. Alright, as you can see, the chat runs perfectly fine, and you've got the stream as well. This is a streamer that I follow called Cranky Canuck. He's an acquired taste for a lot of people, but I love him to bits. Great streamer. But yeah, Beam works perfectly fine. You can watch whatever stream you fancy watching, whatever game you want to watch, whatever stream. It's great. Great service. Definitely recommend it. Alrighty, the next one is Twitch, as you can see. Twitch is Twitch. I don't know what to expect. Oh, yeah, let's watch a RuneScape stream. Why the heck no? Have you got any classics over here? Yeah, which one? Everyone's playing classic. Oh, my God. I used to play this about 10 years ago. Some guys actually made an account called RuneScape Crouchy. Yep, and there it is, playing it with absolutely obnoxious music in the background. Holy crap, that was obnoxious. But yeah, works perfectly fine, chat works fine. I don't really go on Twitch anymore, I mostly go on Beam now. Heck, I even mostly stream to Beam. Beam's a great service, I'll keep peddling it off to everybody because it's just a great service. I'll always have Twitch, but Beam's a more niche thing, I like it. YouTube's YouTube. what do you expect from this? What do you expect? Literally, you could just go onto here and just be like, I don't know. KD Studios Live. And let's watch the most important video on my channel. How about this? Yeah, it's exactly what you'd expect, guys. It's a YouTube app.
Project approaches. Yes.
Yes. Goddamn right, Dan. I know. It's brilliant. Yeah, you can put it in full That's screen. Right. You can watch it at 60 FPS. As you can see, works perfectly fine. Cannot go wrong. Now, quick, before I get a content ID strike off myself. Imagine if you could do that. That'd be awesome. But yeah, media absolutely perfect. Music is music. Do I really need to show you music? Do I really need to? Do I? I don't think I do. I really don't think I do. Let's click on something random. This is all, and what is it? Newgrounds music? Yeah, I've not listened to this music for a while. Ooh, a Doctor Who theme. it's a music app. What do you expect? I don't want to go too much into these things. I just want to show you guys the capabilities of this device. As a media player, you cannot fault it. It is a fantastic media player to plug into your TV. Cannot fault it. And the remote works perfectly well. Let me just point it away from the TV and hope it doesn't change the channel. But there we go. As you can see, you can control it perfectly fine with this remote. What's really cool about this remote is that it actually has a mouse function, so you can use the arrow keys, as you can see, moving it. It's really, really cool. It works perfectly fine, and if you use this remote or the 2.4 gigahertz keyboard mouse remote that I showed you guys a while back, you should definitely try that one out as well. That's the one I've been primarily using with this, because having a keyboard and mouse in one unit as a remote, absolutely great. And plus, playing games on it is fun as well. Okay, so now we're going to look at the PC capabilities of this device. It is an Android operating system in a box, so, you know, if you open up the Play Store, you can download and use any app you want to use. Now, unfortunately, obviously, it doesn't have touchscreen, so a lot of apps are going to be shut away. But if you've got a mouse and keyboard or controller, or heck, even this remote attached to your device via Bluetooth or whatever, you can use that instead. It's absolutely fantastic. So I'm going to show you its PC capabilities now. We do have the Office Suite here. This is the free version of it. I use this on most of my Android devices simply because I use the Excel spreadsheet for my game list. I can go out, whenever I go out and I find games, I look on my game list to see where I've got it in Office Suite. It's absolutely fantastic. This app opens up documents, spreadsheets, PowerPoint, and all sorts of stuff. I don't know its full range of capabilities simply because I only ever use it to read Word documents and spreadsheets, which, to be honest, is all you'd ever really need. Now, you can easily create a nice new document. Apparently, you can make PDF. Oh, no, you scan PDFs. That's adorable. Never really use that. We just use documents and spreadsheets, so you can literally open up the document app side of it, and you can just start tapping away and you'll have it. So let's write a nice new story. The amazing title of Dreams. Once upon a time, there was a bacon sandwich, and it was eaten by me. The end. Congrats, GG. Get good, scrub. There you go, see? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. It's an Office app. You know, I don't need to show you this too much simply because it's an Office app. It works perfectly fine with mouse and keyboard, as you'd expect. Easy. You can choose to save that if you want. We'll save it as a really, really old version because it's got a star by it. Why not? DocX, why not? We shall call it the Amazing Bacon. The Amazing Bacon Sandwich. And we can save that to the cloud, we can save that to local network, it's whatever you expect it to be. So we'll save it in my documents folder, why the heck not? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy, and we can come and open that back up a little bit later if we really wanted to. The file's been saved. Yay! So yeah, it's an Office app. What do you expect from it? Easy peasy. I'll show you CPU-Z so I can actually show you the actual spec of this thing thoroughly, because I completely forgot this app existed. So yeah, it is a ARM Cortex A7, as I expected, a quad-core. As I suspected, it's around 1.5 GHz, that's what it said. It said it goes up to 2 GHz, but no, that's 1.46 clock speed from 408 MHz to 1.46 GHz. And as you can see, it's nice to sit in quite idly, and the GPU render is barely being used. Excellent. It does have 1 GB of RAM, as I, you know, suspected, and the availability of the RAM is very, very meh. It usually uses less than 0.5 GB, so you can't do much graphical intensity with this. But then again, it's not designed to be used as a game console, so there you go. Internal storage, not much left, as you'd expect, but eh. It survives. It does what it needs to. Alrighty, so as a web browsing unit, let's jump into that for a second. I'm not going to show you it. I'm just going to talk about it a little bit. It's not the best web browser. The availability of the RAM severely hurts it. So much so, I'd only recommend using Opera Mini as its browser. Now, Opera Mini is a great little browser for mobile phones. It basically takes websites, compresses it down into really, really tiny images, and sends it back to your device through their own servers. And I believe they've got Adblock installed onto it as well, which is really nice. So, you know, you get an ad-free experience, and you get less, and you use less data, which in a, you know, in a world that uses more and more data is, you know, can be a nice thing. So Opera Mini is always a fantastic option. And what's great is that it doesn't use that many resources on your device either. The default browser is the best browser in my experience. Chrome is such a resource hog, you know, it just hangs after a while. You can open up maybe one page, as soon as you leave that page and open up a new tab and go to another page, it starts hanging, and it's severely slow. So I'd recommend sticking with the default browser. The default browser is probably the best way to do it. But then again, there's not really much you'd want to do on a TV box, would you? I mean, you'd mostly want to watch YouTube, maybe read news articles, but then again, you can get apps for that. Apps would be the best way to approach this. I've used social media apps. I've used Twitter, Facebook, and WhatsApp on here. Yeah, WhatsApp was an interesting one to set up, considering you need a phone. But hey, that was a fun one. But I ended up deleting them simply because I never used them. Of course you don't. It's a TV box. I mean, you can use them for convenience sake, but you just primarily want this for TV. And as a TV box, I can recommend it. Now, if you're looking at this from a perspective I did when I first bought this, I was like, I love Android operating system. I would love to have a dedicated small little Android gaming box. Because, you know, as you saw in the YouTube video, I like MAMEs. I like MAME arcades. So I like units with a bunch of emulators and stuff on it. So, boom, I've installed a ton of emulators. And they work as you'd expect, if I'm honest. Let's play some Super Mario Land. I love Super Mario Land. One of the best games on the system, in my opinion. So, yeah, if you go on Super Mario Land, yay! As you can see, I was already playing a damn game. See if I remember how to actually play this thing. Oh, there we go. Easy peasy. There you go. Runs perfectly fine. I press spacebar to jump. Yep, that runs perfectly fine. I'm gonna fly through these real quickly simply because I don't want to waste your time just showing you what it's capable of. Game Boy is incredibly easy. Any phone can bloody do it. The original iPhone could do it. My Samsung K800, Sony Ericsson K800i old style phone ran Game Boy games. That's easy. Now, what about PlayStation? Yes, this is the interesting one. This one will show its graphical capabilities. So let's jump straight into it. All right. Now, this will show its full capabilities. It's not great. As you can see in the FPS, it can barely hit 60. You have to use quite a bit of frame skipping to get it to run perfectly fine. The sound is also glitchy. And of course, you're not going to get much going for it. But, ow. And I'm not very good with Link, shall you? Woo. Come on, Eddie. Come on. I want to at least beat you up once. Come on, you scrub. Fight me. Die. There you go. I beat him at least once. But yeah. PlayStation, not great. But it works. You can certainly do it. Now, if I quickly exit out of this, let's see, quit, boom. Basically, it runs PlayStation games about as well as you'd expect. It's not the best thing in the universe. I expect it to run things better. As for DS games, for example, I've only tested one game on here simply because I'm not the biggest DS player, and the games I do play, I absolutely adore. It runs Harvest Moon absolutely flawlessly. Look at the frame rate on that. Considering it's, you know, a more advanced system. I mean, it's not exactly super powerful, is it? But it runs very well. And, you know, DS is known for running 3D games quite well. So the emulation runs quite well here. I would like to play these games more often, but I just don't get time to. But yeah, it runs these quite well. And for some reason, it opened up a browser at the end of it. That was weird. Next up, Genesis. I'd show you N64, but I still haven't installed any N64 ROMs. Yeah. Let's go to one of my favorite games of all time. I will always show these games all the time. I'll always go to the same games. Let's see. All right, let's do this. Boom.
So as you can see, it runs Genesis Mega Drive games flawlessly. So if you plug in a controller for this, you're going to have a ton of fun with this. If you want to run any emulated games all the way up to the Genesis, you're perfectly fine to. It runs Super Nintendo, NES, Game Boy, Game Boy Advance. It runs them all perfectly, honestly. It really does. So if you're wanting to buy it for, you know, for games like that, then certainly do it. Do it. There's no reason not to. It runs those perfectly fine. Alrighty, let's get down to the nitty-gritty of it. Video games. Video games. Now, I've only got a few on show here, simply because there aren't actually many that I like to play, and even less that have actual keyboard and mouse support, or controller support, which is, you know, a little bit sad. So, let's show off its capabilities by playing Lander. Man, I used to play this on my aunt's Windows 3.1 computer. A very similar game to this anyway. I can't remember what it was called, but I think this is inspired by that game. I don't even know how I found it, but yeah, basically you have to land your ship. Boom, congratulations. New game again. And it's completely different every single time. And you've got to land it on the flat part pretty easily. Oh, set myself up in the air now. No, and we crashed and burned. Yeah, basic game, basic gameplay, nothing really to show. It can handle basic games that have that type of support. So now something a little bit more graphical, with a little more oomph, a little more graphical fidelity, per se. Pac-Man Championship Edition. Now this is a game worth playing. Goddamn right. It's a Pac-Man Championship Edition. They brought out the latest one recently. No, it doesn't use Enter. Why doesn't it use Enter? It's keyboard support, but not a press Enter. Fair enough, at least it's got mouse support. Let's go over Championship Mode. Real quick gameplay showing of it. It can play Pac-Man. But this is the mobile app version of it, so, you know, you'd be more hard-pressed into finding games that work on this device, to be honest. It does run emulation quite well, which we'll get to, but it can run some quite a few games, and I had a nice goofy mistake there, because of course I did. But it's Pac-Man. Pac-Man's like one of the most easiest games to play. If your device can run any sort of app, it can run Pac-Man. This may be a more graphically demanding version of Pac-Man, but it's still Pac-Man nevertheless. So let's quickly jump out of that, shall we? Let's go on to something a little bit more testing. Gloomy Dungeon. Now, Gloomy Dungeon is more reminiscent of Doom. It's actually a really nice game, and I don't think I've configured it yet, so bear with me while I quickly get through this. Okay, so now we've configured it to use keyboard. Now we should be able to play this video game. Dun, 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 dun. I feel like playing Doom now, because this game really looks like Doom. Hey, action button, all that good stuff. Ooh, got a thing. Pokey, pokey. All right, let's find a thing. Ooh, got the blue key. Excellent. Now hit an enemy. Okay, easy peasy. You die, scrub. Punch in the groin. Yeah, easy peasy. All right. Get a gun at some point. That'd be nice. If lost, press the map button. No, we don't need that. Change weapon and destroy the enemy. Pew, pew, pew. So yeah, it's capable. As you can see, it's quite capable and at a high frame rate, which is always nice. Is there no one in here? I thought there'd be someone in here. Alright, well, tutorial level over. We'll have a quick little run through on the next one, I suppose. Click continue. Continue, because we don't need exposition. And we're in. You guys ready?
It's time to kick ass and chew bubblegum.
And I'm all out of bubblegum. Pew, pew. Easy peasy. There are secrets to be found. This is literally Gloomy Dungeon. There's three versions of the game, I believe. There's this, there's the sequel, and then I think there's another sequel. Don't quote me on that, but I know there's three versions of this game out. And it is very much Doom-inspired. Wolfenstein-inspired. Basically anything with sprites. It's a fun game. Why'd you have to be mad? Right, shoot you, you're all dead. La la la. I think that's everyone. Basically, it's not a very demanding game, and it runs very well. And it's got touchscreen support, as you can see, there's buttons all over the screen, but of course we don't have a touchscreen on this device, but it has controller support and keyboard support, which is very, 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 very nice. And you can actually use your mouse to control it if you're crazy. So that's Gloomy Dungeon. Alrighty, so what are my final thoughts on the TX2 Android PC TV Box, OTT TV Box, PC, mini PC thing? It's got a million different names on eBay. My honest opinion on this? It's bloody brilliant. It's absolutely fantastic for what it is and the price you can find them at. Android PC sticks such as these, little mini PC TV boxes like these are really cheap and really, really powerful for what they are. They're very, very, very versatile. It can run any Android app you really want it to. So long as it's got keyboard and mouse support, it'll pretty much run them very, very easily and very well. The two USB ports, absolutely fantastic. Not many of these little TV sticks actually have this many USB ports. I know, this many, too. I like that it's got a full HDMI port. I like that it takes Ethernet. Ethernet will make it so much better to use. KODI, for my first experience with KODI, I'm very happy with it. But take KODI away from this. Let's say this is just a little Android box without KODI. It's still worth getting as a TV set-top box. You can still get a ton of video streaming apps out there, such as cartoons, anime, and obviously Twitch, Beam, YouTube are all supported by this device. And it's absolutely brilliant. Another thing, I can't believe I wrote this off so early. This thing here, yes. The remote that came with it. Now, I don't know if they all come with a remote like this, but this remote was absolutely brilliant. With the exception that it turns my TV off. I can't remember which button does it, but one of these buttons turns my TV off, which is very, very annoying, obviously. It doesn't do anything to that TV over there, and it doesn't do it to the TV next to it, so it's literally just the TV I was using for the review, which is my problem, not a problem with the remote. But hey, if this thing comes with this TX2, go pick one up now, because this remote's brilliant, and I think you might be able to bind it to other devices. I didn't try, and I'm not going to try, simply because I want to keep these together. It's a very nice little set TV box, and I'm actually going to keep this on the main TV over there, simply because it's a nice little TV box, and it'll be great for just sit back and relax on the couch, watch some Beam, interrupt the streams with my lovely 2.4 GHz wireless remote. So, I could do that as well. Honestly, if you want a Android streaming TV box, this is pretty good, or anything better than this. So always look at the spec. If you can find this and but better, pick it up. It's crazy. I've shown you what you can do with this. Imagine what you can do with an upgraded version, with a higher CPU and a better graphics in it. So go for it. Go pick one up. If you're looking for a little mini PC, this is pretty good as well. This is a very nice alternative to having a nice big PC. Depends what you want to use it for. If you just want a little office PC, this is cheap. This'll do. You could use your phone, if I'm honest. But if you just want a dedicated device where you can just do things on, this is pretty nice. You can just plug it into your TV and you'll be good to go. Or monitor. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. So let me know what you guys think of this device. Is it worth having, or is it too old and archaic to even consider having? I do have a couple more devices like this, and I will be showing more in the future, so stay tuned for those, guys. I'll see you guys next time. Stay safe, and go stream some anime. This is awesome.